Right, welcome back to another training vlog. This week, I'm going to do something that I've been meaning to do for the last few weeks, and that's basically bring you along for a whole week of training to give you an idea of what kind of overall volume looks like, what the individual sessions look like, and how I'm getting them in throughout the day. I've kind of already fucked this up a small bit because it's Monday evening. I went for a short run before work. It was just like a 3K, very slow pace, but just to get moving, basically. It's around 10 to 7 in the evening now. I have jiu-jitsu training at 8, so I'm going to go for a quick 3K now. It won't be a crazy pace, but it'll just be yet another running session throughout the week. So I'll talk to you.
So, nice handy one. I just did an 800, a 400, and a 600. Like, small bit of rest in between. Perfect, really. Getting ready to go training in like 45 minutes.
Right, so nearly at the gym now. This is in between workout meal, so banana and a Ribena or a juice box, whatever you want to call it. Some sugar, a liter of water, and we're good to go. Just finished jiu-jitsu class.
Good class?
Very good class.
Good class, yeah.
Exceptionally good class. Very tired now.
Intensity wasn't too bad though for the class. You know, I think it was a good pace.
Nice, bit of rolling afterwards.
Yeah, only 5 minutes King of the Hill, like really, like knowing techniques more than...
Yeah.
It's a Monday class.
You don't
need to kid yourself in a
Monday. Highly technical.
Yeah.
Which obviously doesn't suit my game at all.
No, because Dara's are...
So yeah, up early and at the running again in the morning. Okay, so welcome to Wednesday. It's like 6:45 p.m. So this is a track session. Today's going to be mainly 800s. Didn't get to train yesterday just due to some work stuff and some trying to get my Jeep sorted stuff. Right, so that's that running session done. Ended up being around half an hour. There's actually an athletics club on the track. So that wasn't ideal. But yeah, a few 800s, a few 400s afterwards. Nice handy pace, just still trying to get some volume up. Yeah, that's the only session for today. We'll be back with a running session in the morning. One thing I forgot to mention is that when your polar watch is on 3% or less, it doesn't give you pacing or time, which isn't really ideal. But yeah, it's definitely something I need to keep in mind with this. I just assumed it would kind of go all the way until it gave up, but it won't. Right, it's about 10:30 on Wednesday evening. Still, we're going to do a quick 3K now, but more importantly, you're going to get to see how mental Seiko goes when she's told she's going for a walk.
Six. Do you want to go for a walk? Do you want to go for a walk? Do you want to go for a walk? Come on.
So, good handy run. Very, very easy pace, like 5.5, 6 minute kilometers. Perfect. It was nice and rainy and dark, so it was quite cool. Yeah, that's Wednesday's training done. Okay, so it's 5:20 on Thursday evening. We're driving to the UK in the morning for that training camp.
Okay, so this is UCC. This is where I do nearly all my track running, or actually all of my track running at the moment. This is my my alma mater. So it's where I went to college for a few years. The running track there is quite good. They have pretty good facilities overall. So this running session went down fairly well. I'm getting a fair bit of tightness in my lower back, just a small bit of that twinge in my shin coming back again. So after each of the running sessions, I'm just doing as much kind of lower back stretching out as possible, just kind of cramps up, and just a bit of static stretching, not for too long, does tend to help it quite a bit. Friday evening session. This is when we've just literally arrived in Epsom to start the training camp on Saturday. So we were giving a seminar for the weekend, myself and Gerf were, with Gabriel St. Crean in Ascension Training in Epsom, just outside of London. So we were driving for the day on Friday to get over from Ireland. Once we arrived, we basically just headed straight to the gym. I did some squat doubles at 160 and then tried out their air runner. I'm not going to lie, the air runner was unbelievably difficult to run on. I could see it being absolutely great for like 400 meter repeats or something, or even 200 meter repeats, but it's very difficult to maintain a pace on it. It's a really strange running gait. I don't know, I couldn't get the hang of it. I found it to be quite difficult. So the next day, on Saturday at our lunch break, just went for a nice 2K around Epsom town itself. Very, very nice part of the south of England. And then after that, I did 130 for a set of 10. So nice and easy. Feeling quite good here. Back is a small bit tight, but basically just walked straight in and did 100 for a set of a couple of reps and then went to 130. So these 130s felt quite good. I was actually very disappointed in myself because for some strange reason, I just thought it was 150. And I thought 150 felt very good for 10s. So it wasn't actually. Yet another time of perceived exertion lying to me. Then for Sunday, I didn't do any running. Gabriel and Gerf were going a fair bit heavier on their lifts, so I just followed in. I actually got a treatment with a therapist in Epsom in the gym, Rocco. So he was working on my back, helping me through some stuff. And then I fell in with Gabriel. So Gabriel was at 90 kilos. When I got around to start training, so I just started with power clean doubles and triples at 90. I had planned just to go up to around 120 or 30 on the power clean. These feel very, very good at this point. Rob is abusing me for not warming up here, but these feel good. I'm moving fast. Power cleans always tend to feel quite good, to be honest. The main things I'm looking for is not making too much contact. So I'm actually thinking about making no contact at all as I'm setting up. That's all that's going through my head. And then I like to move my feet fast. So they're the only two real cues I ever think about for power cleans. I used to think about holding onto the bar, trying to really pull hard on the bar, but right now I just think about not making contact and moving my feet as much as possible. This the next one then. 120, nice easy power clean. Just with a belt, no knee sleeves. And then this is 130. So I can't remember if this is a power clean or not. Maybe not. Yeah, no, it's not. I just dropped underneath it. And then obviously, if you've gone to a full clean to make 130, you're just going to go to a full clean to make 140 afterwards. So I think this is the first full clean I've done since September. And yeah, it's pretty easy. I was fairly happy with that. So thanks for watching the training vlog. I'll talk to you all again soon.